Heyo everybody, Haku here, coming at you with my live reaction to One Piece Manga Chapter 857, or Rook. Let's go ahead and get into reading and discussing this one and everything, and of course the review will be up tomorrow, as always, with any hope. I'm hoping to have it up, like, first thing tomorrow morning, just because I have some other videos to do tomorrow as well. But as for this chapter, starting off with the title, I think Rook is probably in some connection to Capone, actually, because, you know, a rook is like a turret, like a mini castle in a way, and Capone has the Shiro no Mi, or Castle Fruit, so I'm just gonna guess Rook has something to do with Capone. We haven't really seen him in a while, other than assuming that he's the one that shot Bobbin. So yeah, other than that, we haven't seen him in a bit. And hello at the beginning, Hancock enjoying the pool. Hello, Hancock. Hancock is super sexy, and I think almost one of the reasons I like Hancock so much is because she reminds me of one of my favorite characters from Railgun, which was Kongo Mitsuko, because they both have the same haircut, they both have a giant snake. So yeah, I really do enjoy the character. Alright, now we have Sweet City Outskirts. A quiet rain falls on the two. Jinbei showed up, says Sanji. Yeah, I was totally surprised, too. Tsunami's safe, then. I'm so relieved. But anyway, now we've just got to think about how we can meet up with everyone. They'll all be stoked once they hear you're coming back. Shishishi. Nami and Co. were worried more than anyone after all. And in spite of... Oh, I can't possibly look Nami in the eye after everything I've done. I didn't see that at the bottom there. Nami and company were more worried than anyone after all. And in spite of that, I caused them all terrible grief. Oh, the rain's letting up. Mirror world. There they are. You think they'll be able to hear us, even through these tiny mirror fragments? Ah, that's the mirror they broke when they were with Bomb. The last mirror we used to talk with you was broken while I was riding on top of the giant tree creature who called himself King Bomb, so... Hello, Chopper? She has the... of course, we see the flashback to remind us. There has to be at least a couple of pieces lying around that area. Luffy, hey! Chopper is yelling into a tiny little mirror piece. And then Sweet City Outskirts, we hear him, hey! Luffy, are you there? That's Chopper's voice. Hey! Found it. It's coming from this little piece of mirror, and it's just this tiny little shard. Luffy, can you hear me? Why is there a voice coming from the mirror, says Sanji. It's a long story, but all you need to know is that Chopper's inside the mirror with everyone else. Chopper, are you guys all right? Ah, Luffy, you're really there. I'm so glad. Sanji's so surprised. Luffy, do you have Sanji with you, says Nami? Yep, he's right here. What about you? And then Carrot says, we were able to find and rescue everyone from inside the mirrors, Luffy. And what's more, says Chopper, Brook was actually able to get his hands on a copy of the Poneglyph. Whoa, really? You guys are the best. Even if you praise me, it won't make me happy or anything, you bastard. And then Carrot says, hey, you bastard. And then Brook, yo-ho-ho, you dunderhead. Oh my gosh. Luffy, it's great that Sanji's with you, says Pedro, but were you able to reach an understanding? Sanji's not coming back just yet, he says, and then they're all surprised, eh? Then, starting now, we're gonna bust up Big Mom's tea party and wedding and save Sanji's family, and once we're done, Sanji'll come back to us. Big, they all just get silent. Luffy, we're talking about a Yonko here, says Sanji. The last thing I want is to endanger everyone. No, endanger Nami because of my own selfishness. That's why... And we see all of Nami's group. Yay! They all start cheering out of the mirror. And then we have Chopper crying, what the hell's your problem? I had heard you had a huge fight with Luffy, so I was crazy worried, you dummy. I'm just so happy, you dummy, says Carrot. You simpleton, says Brook. As long as we do all that, Sanji will come back with the crew, right? Says Nami. Sanji, regarding the matter of throwing me down into the depths of fear itself. I'll never forgive you, she says. But I suppose I can put it behind me for the time being. The tea party's just around the corner, after all. So I'm gonna bring you back, even if I have to drag you. Got it, Sanji? Could you be proposing to be Nami? This all makes me feel oddly relieved. Well then, says Jinbei, Luffy, we all know what we've got to do. Yep, and now that I think of it, Sanji's big sister saved my life. Ah, then we must save her at all costs. But that's easier said than done, even though we don't necessarily have to take out Big Mom herself. Every time Mama has a tea party, she looks forward to it from the very bottom of her heart. To destroy all that would mean to incite the full-blown wrath of one of the Yonko. And what's more, you all, it seems you've already been confronted by various ministers, but within the Big Mom Pirates, they are but the tip of the iceberg. There will surely be many fierce warriors above even them in attendance at the tea party, and not to mention the emperors of the underworld invited from various nations across the sea. As for we who are standing against them, there are merely 10 of us. Hey, don't you include us in this mess, says Brulé, yelling in the background. Don't go fudging the numbers, there's merely 8 of you, not 10. And you can all go get yourselves murdered as far as I'm concerned. Luffy, I already talked about this with everyone on this side, but forgive me for changing the subject, but there's something you need to hear. Do you know of Capone Gang Beje? Yeah, he's the guy who made off with Sanji, says Luffy. Right. He's one of the worst generation, in other words, one of your contemporaries. In his native West Blue, there are 5 enormous mafias which have the underworld of the entire sea under their control. I feel sort of like Capone is in fact a traitor to Big Mom trying to take her down as well. The 5 great families of the West, and the 5 bosses of those mafia, one of them is none other than Gang Beje himself. The moniker Gang comes from the remnants of his younger days, and he was one crazy whippersnapper. He became infamous as a loose cannon, you see. I've heard that he's the sort of man who'd cut off animals' heads and laughed as he watched their writhing bodies. What? That's beyond terrible. And if you change animals to organizations, they met the very same fate at his hands. Even back in his younger days, he was already gunning for the heads of the bosses of the underworld. Even if they commanded an entire family, he'd go straight for the head of the boss, who dared resist him, and no one else. But in spite of all that, he showed no interest in improving his status or acquiring territory. He stole money and precious items and nothing else. So I feel like that's sort of his goal here. He's not trying to take down the Big Mom family, just Big Mom herself, because then the family won't oppose him if the leader is gone. Cut off the head and the snake will die kind of strategy. From then on, he sat back and watched the blood-soaked struggles for power. He merely laughed as he watched the powers that be in the underworld panic. Saying he's a man with bad taste would be an understatement. However, in this world, it's an eye for an eye. Before long, those who would seek revenge on him came for his head in droves. And yet, that was all fun and games for Beje. He had an ironclad fortress awaiting them, and sent them packing with their tails between their legs, laughing all the while. And once he grew bored of his dominance of the land, he set out to the seas, but his methodologies did not change. He quickly gained infamy by taking only the heads of renowned pirate captains, but leaving their crews intact. And why are you telling all of this to us now, Jinbei? Says Luffy. Even when he journeyed out to sea, he was continuously chased by those seeking revenge. And to someone like that, there's no better hiding place than under the umbrella of a Yonko. So Beige became a subordinate of Big Mom's. And now, his sharpened wariness, in addition to his defensive prowess, have had their value acknowledged. And as of this tea party, he's finally earned the title of Rook as a combatant in Big Mom's forces, and has been given full authority over the security detail of the event. Yo, so he might be planning something at the wedding as well. Since he and his men will be on guard duty, that means there will be no one to get in his way. Huh? The main event of this tea party is the wedding ceremony. And as you know, Big Mom is planning on slaughtering every one of the Vinsmokes at that ceremony, and obtaining all of the Germa for herself. But amidst all the festivities, Beige intends to take Big Mom's head then and there. What? Oh my gosh. I freaking love that panel and just love this whole story. Like, just saying that, okay, Beige is betraying Big Mom is one thing, but this was a pretty awesome backstory we're going through. Are you serious? This tea party is just steeped with conspiracy, says Sanji. Luffy, as for Peckham's who guided you all here, the truth is, he was taken by Beige and his cohorts and was offered to become an accomplice with their schemes. Peckham's, so that's where he went. But Peckham's, who has a strong sense of duty, refused the offer, and in order to ensure that he was kept quiet, he was shot and dropped into the sea for the sharks to feed on him. However, luckily for him, he was found by one of my comrades and saved by a hair's breadth, and he's currently recuperating. So he's safe then, I'm glad to hear it. But I've had it up to here with this beige bastard. I'll never forgive him. Luffy, from here on out is the meat of the conversation. I've heard everything about this plan from Peckham's himself, and I've done quite a bit of thinking on how you all should act from here. Yo, so it is kind of like I'm saying, fatal four-way, by God, between the Straw Hats, Big Mom, the Jerma, and the fire tanks, essentially. Once you heard this whole story, I knew you would want to rescue Sanji and his entire family. I certainly feel bad for Peckham's, but is now really the time to make an enemy of Beje? The tea party will begin at 10 a.m. That's only about 5 hours away. Unlike the 10 of us who, starting now, we're trying to make a plan from scratch. I told you not to include us in your little schemes. You fiends, I'll expose all of this. Just you wait, says Brulee yelling in the background. Beje and his crew have meticulously made preparations for this day. Sanji, Luffy, would you join forces with Beige? What? Oh my gosh, Jinbei asking him to team up with Beige, the hype man. Hold on, we have this big two-page panel that I gotta get into. What's up? Come on. And that's the last panel of the thing too. Hold on, I actually accidentally skipped forward. It's the last page. Okay, let's go. You might be onto something there, says Luffy. Whoa, Luffy, are you insane? Says Sanji. Luffy, you haven't actually been taken in by Jinbei, have you? Says Sanji. Or, says Nami. See, what did I tell you? Just what I thought he'd say, says Jinbei, laughing. Luffy, we voted against it, 4-2. I've actually already made preparations for a meeting. Should we go see him? All right, let's meet with him right away. Okay, so I'll be onto something there. They voted against it 4-2. Let's see, who voted for what? It seems like Jinbei certainly voted for it, and I guess Carrot or Pedro was the other vote for it, because it seems like Chopper and Nami are against it. Okay, interesting. Calm down. If we don't like the sound of it, we can just turn him down. Our objectives are slightly different after all. Northwest Whole Cake Island, Fire Tank Pirates Hideout. I am pretty hype now. So did you off Bobbin? Indeed I did. He was chasing after Blackleg and, well, the Jerma are my heroes after all, Nyororo. So confirmation that Vito is the one that took down Bobbin. Bobbin, like I said, catching eternal L's. Do yous really think those guys are coming, Father? Jinbei isn't a man who'd joke around about something like this. It's only logical that neither of us would want to make ourselves more enemies, given that we're both planning on opposing Big Mom, says Capone. The rest all depends on the Straw Hat's attitude. If he does anything to piss me off, all we gotta do is take him out right here. Gang is gonna give Luffy an offer he can't refuse. Yo, I like this. Because we've been wondering who, like, everybody was guessing and they were thinking maybe Drake, wondering who the next part of Luffy's alliance might be. It will be quite surprising if it's actually Capone and the fire tanks. I mean, sure, they're kind of bad guys, so they're probably not gonna be, like, full-on allies, but that doesn't mean we can't work with them for now. Let's take a look at his crew, though. The background guys don't seem that important. The only ones that seem important are Vito, of course, his right-hand man. And then we have this dude with the crazy hair who looks at he almost looks like Caesar Clown. He looks pretty important. And same with the what's his name? Gotti, the dude with the big arm. Man, I'm really hyped about this. And we get a chapter next week. This was a good chapter. Like, I felt like it was a long, meaty chapter. Even though most of it was Capone backstory, it was really good. I really sincerely enjoyed this. And just seeing all our characters reconnect and talk to each other was great. So yeah, no complaints here. I'll think more about it, read it again, and have a review of it up tomorrow, as usual. Like I said, with any and all hope, tomorrow morning. But either way, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like, if you did like the video, my lighting seems really weird in this one. Just now noticed. Subscribe for more One Piece, both anime and manga, and a ton of other anime, manga, and more. Comment down there, tell me what you thought of my first thoughts and reaction to this chapter, and what you thought of the chapter itself. Follow on Twitter if you want, I'll try to keep you updated there and stuff for the channel, and also just random shit, honestly. That's it, share the video if you want and all that, and thank you for watching. I'll see you all next time.